Welcome to the Hanbridge Mandarin HSK program. Today we'll compare two words, 比 and 比较. These two words have very similar meanings and similar character components. Both of them can be used to compare the similarities and the differences among the same kinds of objects. However, there are different parts of speech. A frequent usage of比 is this pattern, 与和跟比. It's used to compare one thing with another. When speaking, we can also use 与和跟比较. So, in this case, they can be used almost interchangeably. Let's look at some examples.
和北京比，深圳暖和多了。和北京比，深圳暖和多了。和北京比较，深圳暖和多了。和北京比较，深圳暖和多了。跟学汉语比。学英语更简单。跟学汉语比，学英语更简单。跟学汉语比较，学英语更简单。跟学汉语比较，学英语更简单。和上学期比，这学期他的成绩更好。和上学期比，这学期他的成绩更好。和上学期比较，这学期他的成绩更好。和上学期比较，这学期他的成绩更好。
Even though they are almost the same in the above sentences, they have some differences in other usage. For instance, 比 is often used in this pattern. 比 here is used to emphasize the subject's comparative degree, which means A is more adjective than B. But比较 is used differently. For example,
他比我高。他比我高。昨天比今天冷。昨天比今天冷。
To show a comparative degree,比较 is used as an adverb before the adjective. There should also be some explanation before the comparison. Let's see some examples.
你的想法和他的想法。我觉得你的比较合理。你的想法和他的想法。我觉得你的比较合理。苹果和香蕉，我比较喜欢苹果。苹果和香蕉，我比较喜欢苹果。
比较 ，it can be a verb meaning to compare as well, but 比 cannot be used this way. For example,
请比较这两本书的。不同，请比较这两本书的不同。他们两人之间经常会比较。他们两人之间经常会比较。不要总拿别人的孩子和自己的比较。不要总拿别人的孩子 和自己的比较。比较
When it is used as an adverb, it can express a certain degree. The degree depends on the context, but 比 cannot be used this way. For example,
事情比较复杂，我们得想想怎么处理。
事情比较复杂，我们得想想怎么处理。
他什么也不会，求职比较困难。
他什么也不会，求职比较困难。
这道题已经讲得比较清楚了。
这道题已经讲得比较清楚了。
Okay, that's all for the comparison of 比 and 比较。
Here's a small quiz to check if you can use them correctly. If you want to know whether you got your answers right or not, please leave them at the comment area. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please subscribe. See you next time. Thank you.